Hello guys, let's talk about poetry in Chaucer's age in today's video. And I hope you liked the video, previous videos you have watched, and you have made your proper notes. Now we are going to talk about poetry, particularly poetry, then we will talk about prose. And in this section, we will be talking about the lifespan of Geoffrey Chaucer. And his works are categorized in three parts, so we will be talking about them too. So in this particular video, we will be talking about the Chaucer's characters and his poetry. Okay, this is very important to understand all the facts. And later in other video, we will be talking about his three periods in Chaucer's poetic career. So let's start today's video and start making the notes. And please don't forget to share the video after watching this video. So let's start. Poetry presents a strange amalgam of love, religion, and chivalry. If you don't know what amalgam means, it means the mixture. Okay, the love, religion, and chivalry. Tino cheeze hame milti hain. The cardinal characteristics of medievalism on the one hand and of humanism and secular spirit of the other. So we know that medievalism, what does medievalism means right now? Medievalism means the stories of sea, stories of war, stories, okay, some songs and some alliterative. Okay, so whenever there is a word medievalism, जब भी आपको एक word medievalism मिलेगा, उसका मतलब ये सारी चीजें होंगी. Okay, so आप लोगों के mind में बिल्कुल clear होनी चाहिए ये बात अब कि जब भी हम medievalism की बात करेंगे, हम इन चीजों के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं. Okay, so जो poetry थी, वो कौन सी थी? Sea, war, and some songs, alliterative verse, ये सारी चीजें की बात कर रहे थे. Okay, तो एक तरफ तो ये चल रहा था. And second things were and of humanism. Now humanism entered into poetry and literature. Remember this. Okay, after some wars, you remember Lollard movements and other wars, the French wars and 100 years wars, there was a term humanism, came into existence. Later, some secular spirit on the other. So now if we read about Geoffrey Chaucer, we should know about these things too. The greater part of poetry is medieval, but there are clear signs of breaking away from the past. Now, if you see the works by Geoffrey Chaucer, you will feel that now we are breaking away from the past. He is no longer writing about sea, wars and other things. Okay, he is concerned with individual person. और जब आप आएंगे धीरे 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 इंडिविजुअल को पढ़ते हुए मॉडर्न पीरियड तक आएंगे, तो आपको एक आपको मिलेगा, वहाँ पे एक टर्म मिलेगा, ट्रांसेंडेंटलिज्म. ओके, सो यू विल कम टू ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट एंड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दोज टर्म्स बेटर इफ़ यू ट्राई टू लिंक ईच एंड एवरीथिंग, सारी चीज़ों को लिंक करने की कोशिश कीजिए. ऑल राइट, और कमेंट बॉक्स में जरूर लिख लीजिए कि अगर आपको ये चीज़ें समझ आ रही हैं और शुड आई change some ways. Okay, so please do write down in comment box. English alliterative verse was revived about the middle of the 14th century, but under French influence, rhymed verse had gained supremacy. Now, alliterative verse are, losing the ground, and French rhymed verses are in, supreme position. Modernization and in language and style were clearly perceptible. अब आप क्या देख सकते हैं? क्या आप मॉडर्नाइजेशन देख सकते हैं इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज का? नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट चौसर्स लाइफ. चौसर द ग्रेटेस्ट लिटरेरी फिगर ऑफ एज वॉज स्कॉलर, ट्रैवलर, बिजनेसमैन, कोर्टियर एंड एन एक्टिव शेयरर. अब इस पार्ट का, अगर इस पार्ट को मैं कहूँ कि इस पार्ट का क्या मतलब है इंग्लिश लिटरेचर को समझने में, अगर आप इस बात को समझते हैं कि ही वॉज अ ट्रैवलर, इफ यू हैव इन माइंड दैट ही इज अ ट्रैवलर, ही इज अ बिजनेसमैन, ही इज अ कोर्टियर, एक्टिव शेयरर, so you will understand his works better when you will be reading Canterbury Tales. You will understand him better. Okay, he reflected his age in literature, okay, as no other but Shakespeare has ever done. So we are comparing Shakespeare to Geoffrey Chaucer or Geoffrey Chaucer to Shakespeare in this way. His life, Chaucer was born on born about 1340, we take this year, so remember this one. He was son of John Chaucer, a winter, or of Thames, Thames Street, sorry, London. At the age of 16, he became page of the wife Leonel, Duke of Clarence. 1359, he went with the king's army to France. So remember, he went to France, and wherever he went, he learned something, and he came back and applied those things in his writing. जब भी वो वापस आते थे तो कुछ नॉलेज लेके आते थे. He was captured but ransomed before the Treaty of Bertingley in 1360. This is asked in some exams. On his return to England, Chaucer became an esquire of the King's bedchamber. He spent the next 10 years at Edward's court. So he was in Edward's court that time. Chaucer went on and he made several official journeys in between 1368 to 1387. And remember, this was the date when he started writing Canterbury Tales. And his journeys to his journey to Italy markedly affected his poetic talent. So you remember, wherever he went, he met some men and he learned some manners and about his fashion. So in his work, in his magnum opus is Canterbury Tales, and there you can see. And in 18th, this is again the important year in his life, he lost the court favor and everything, you know, he lost his money and everything. But later, the succession of Henry IV, the son of John of Gaunt. So remember, this is John of Gaunt. चौसर का एक वर्क है, इसको मैं आप लोगों को जैसे आगे उस वर्क के बारे में बात करूंगा, उस टाइम मैं आपका ध्यान इस पर खींचने की कोशिश करूंगा कि जॉन ऑफ गाउंट के बारे में ही क्यों लिखा उसने, किसी और के बारे में क्यों नहीं लिखा, वाइफ ऑफ जॉन गाउंट के बारे में क्यों लिखा. ठीक है, बून टू चौसर, और उन्हें काफ़ी सारी पेंशन उस टाइम मिलने लग गई थी, और इसमें 1400 में ही पास्ड अवे एंड देन ही वॉज बरीड इन पोइट्स कॉर्नर. सो रिमेंबर दीज थिंग्स, 1386, John of Gaunt, Henry IV, okay, Edward III. So you should remember these things. Now let's talk about a little Chaucer's characters and his poetry, and then we will come to we will talk about other things. So if we are talking about his characterization, we know that Chaucer lived in urban and aristocratic society. Remember this thing. That's why it influenced his character also. And if we want to sum up this everything, he was a good scholar and keep observer of nature too. And we will come to this remark by W.H. Hudson, and he said that like Shakespeare and Milton, he was on the contrary a man of the world and of affairs. He had traveled much, he had seen life. His business at home and abroad brought him into intimate relationship with people all sorts, and the quick insight into characters and his keen interest, his keen eye for everything dramatic and picturesque and humorous, he was precisely the kind of poet to profit by such varied experience. So I want to tell you that if we go through the poet's life and characterization, we get more interest in his works. When you will read Canterbury Tales, you will find more interest if you know each and every poet, where he went and what Italy, when he went to Italy, what he brought from Italy, from France, what he brought from France. Okay, so these things will help you definitely in understanding more English literature. In next video, we will be talking about three periods in Chaucer's poetic career. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to share. Please do share the video and do like the video for ranking purpose. Bye-bye. Take care. See you and good luck for exams.